So, remember when I said I had to make a contact to get a car flown out here to kind of do that little thing that Spike wants me to do? Well, this is that car that I was talking about. Its previous owner, Suki, I think previously destroyed it in one of the Fast and Furious movies, and that car was never seen. Well, actually, I think it was seen again. Was it seen again? Yeah, it was. Yeah, so it was fixed during that movie, but then after that, it was never shown again. So, one of the rap artists for this game created the same car, so to speak. They just created the rap design for it. I just kind of filled in the gaps with the more aerodynamic designs and wheels to make it look kinda almost like the original car. So it's kinda almost like the original car, but a little bit different. So, all right, and it meets the criteria. So it's under 250 horses. I think it's 249. But because I like aero, it's gonna sail like a streamlined butterfly down the road. It's like beautiful music, beautiful music. Unlike, oh man, Gran Turismo Sport. When you go into cockpit view in that game, it is wow. Oh my God, it's like a horror movie. Oh, it's that funny. It's like you can barely hear the sound of the engine over the whine of the supercharger. It is that loud. So yeah, there's some balancing issues going on. So. After all, it's just a bit. It's not the actual product. It's close to the actual product, so they gotta work out some bugs here and there. But you know, overall, it does look kinda similar to other Gran Turismo games. People kissing the cars in your games. I know it's kinda hard because they have like over 1,000 cars, you know, supposedly in their games almost all the time. So it's like, well, can't really do much in terms of like new car innovations. That's why they kind of created their own thing with the their original designs. So yeah. Suki, I thank you for letting me use your car. Yeah, so actually keeping this thing below 250 was not that difficult. So basically he's out putting the NOS. I think I have a upgraded suspension. Basically, I did all the stuff that would increase the horsepower, and basically add an aero kit to it, and that was that. Got through it, one piece, no crashes, good to go. And this asshole behind me. I'm trying to have a intellectual conversation inside my car to myself and to my audience. I want to talk about all the things I usually can't talk about because I'm around other people and they don't understand the YouTube grind of like talking to yourself and talking about your favorite things. A one-time used car. Yeah, it's earned a spot in my garage for now. The Honda S2000. It was the villain car of the first Fast and Furious, but a hero car in the second one.
Dude, my phone's blowing up. Everybody and their dog knows what you did. We're on the way, man. Let's hit another route, turn it up a notch. Kick ass, man.
It's like Spike finds the route. I drive the route, so who should get credit? I mean, I'm the guy driving through all this crap and doing all these, like, you know, insane times, but Spike's like, well, he's just a front man, the pusher. He hypes everything up. But he doesn't deliver on his own. That is his mistake. That's basically everybody's mistake except for Amy, because she actually, Amy and Robin and Manu, because they actually do some impressive stuff in the game, but Spike, he's kind of like the ass of the team. And Travis is off doing his own thing in his corner. Which begs to mention, who is the unofficial leader of this group of misfits? Yeah, it's probably Travis. He's the networking guy.
Here he is. Let's get going.
Like, I just came in out of nowhere. Wow, somebody's jelly. Yeah, so Suki's car is just a cameo appearance in this game. There are a lot of other cameos too, but I don't think I found them all. So, yeah. I know this one really famous one that, you know, it's kind of in some of the screenshots for the races. But, yeah, I think, canon-wise, that car was destroyed in Palma Bay. And if you don't know what car I'm talking about, just play Need for Speed Most Wanted and then play Carbon right after that. And they kind of link both games together, because basically Most Wanted happens after Carbon and then before Carbon. So what I think EA was trying to do was that they're trying to set up a prequel to Carbon to kind of show you, you know, like the birth of the M3 GTR. Yeah, it became like a beast, but yeah, they plans kind of fell through with Undercover and Pro Street. Then they shift to, not the original shift, then shift to two. It is like super bright today. Got like crazy reflections coming from the screen. It's time to go. Daniel Tiger's neighborhood. On PBS. Rated TV-14. Epic fail. Well, I want to see them try to do this event with cops on their ass.
That was fun. A lot more to do, so don't bail yet.
Yeah, I'm a bit, I'm kind of in a hot pursuit right now, so yeah, I gotta bail. It's like, can it be? Are you the true successor to the Lamborghini? Nah. I still like my car, though. It's a damn good car. And it's gonna be damn hard to replace it, too. It treated me so well in Rockport. So well. I'm gonna say it now. I think Robin's smashing one of the guys from Risky Devil. I don't know who it is, though. It might be Fish. Or the other guy. Forget his name. And that's why Spike's always hating her. Or maybe why he went up her car. Because she has a BMW, and he has a BMW, but a better model. A BMW. Nice bobbing and weaving. I like that bridge. That is a cool ass bridge. Crazy top speed. Yeah, I'm in a McLaren, so you can't really match this thing. actually, there is a car in this game that is actually faster than this, but
What the hell?
What? Okay, that was kind of new. I thought she was pissed for a second. Because usually when a phone call starts with what the hell, isn't that usually anything good, FYI? I'm on the outside, looking in. I think these people are using me because of my skills. But what they don't know is that I am very skilled for a reason. It's because I'm undercover.
The rock star has arrived.
They just don't know. I'm after Travis and all his little friends. You see, secretly, this game has a better storyline than Need for Speed Undercover. Because it's subtle. Right up until the moment you know you get into a black and white car and you have to kind of do some bad things. Yeah, you see when I step out like that, basically I'm just like bleeding off speed. And that's a fast way of just braking, because my brakes actually suck. Because they have so little power. Even when they're like top of the line. Yeah, even when I do get the top of the line brakes and e-braking system, basically I turn all the power down. So that way I can like initiate. Well, actually, on the e-brake I turn it down, and on the actual brakes I turn it all the way up. So that way I can initiate drifts like a lot easier. So yeah, a lot of thought goes behind making these cars do what they do. Or in trying to find the sweet spot. Like with the H2000 earlier in the video, that car was at the sweet spot. No. It was around that. If you get around the sweet spot, you can basically do pretty much what you want to do in the game. And if you're dead on it, basically you're like, you're just golden. No one can touch you. So, What's the deal with Manu and that grip thing? The handshake. Yeah, he's probably a man's man or something like that. So you got Manu with the grip thing, you got Travis looking me up and down like I'm a piece of meat. So, yeah. I guess everybody wants me in this game. What the hell? Well, it's a circuit, so hopefully I'm not too far behind. Okay, yeah. Yeah, I gotta do some dangerous driving right now. One second. It's over. It's a straight. No! Spoke too soon. Son of a bitch. I jinxed myself. It's over. Damn. I tried to bring it back, and I shot my mouth off, and I paid. You know, honestly, I thought I was driving against Robin for a second, but yeah, it's just Mike. That acceleration! From last to first in under 10 seconds. You know, for being the budget McLaren, this thing's not that bad. I mean, it looks great in the back, it looks great in the front, but then you always have in the back of your mind that there's always a better McLaren out there and you just couldn't afford it. Yeah. So this is kind of a double-edged sword of a car. And you're always having that thought where it's like, well, if I saved up a little bit more, I could have got the better version. Yeah, because there's nothing wrong with having a V8 in a supercar. It's just like, it's like if you're spending like $200,000 on a car, you don't want a V8 in there. You want some exotic shit in there, like a V10 or a V12. Like, man, I could buy like a V for like $50,000. Yeah, someone had the same idea as you, and yeah, it's getting pretty violent. Yeah, they cut the camera. I don't know, this game is rated T, right? Yeah, it's rated T. Have to look at the box for a second to figure out the rating. Drag brake. Now I know the difference between drag and shit. Let's see. One property is called drag. The other property is called stuff drag. Something else. Arrow.
Hey, it's Fish.
Downforce.
Came by to talk to Robin. Heard you're not much to
talking on the phone. I respect that. So I'm headed up to Southport. Cruise up and let's shred. Gotta see these mad skills for myself. Later.
Trigger, the wind decelerates me, and then when I put my finger back on the trigger, the engine accelerates me. There we go. Yeah, it's kind of hard to think when you're moving this fast. Which is why the faster you go, the simpler your thoughts have to be.
Chumps, man. Right, meet me at Longhorn. Ooh, you know this thing's gonna blow up, right? I'd like to see what Magnus thinks now, man. Later.
Spike, I think you eat too much red meat at Longhorn's. It's not good for you, man. So, yeah. One mini.
Okay, dude, let's see what you got.
Hey, fish, are you banging Robin? I mean, I don't think she's here. Oh, look at that, it's a circuit. One, two, two, one, two. Awesome. In order to become the god of drifting, you must first intake Corona. You know, I'm kind of, you can. It's like, usually in the country, you start drinking Monster energy drinks, and it's like, I know they're a big sponsor and all, but, you know, how about Corona? I mean, come on, usually guys like that would be drinking Corona, but then it's like, oh, they're kind of promoting, like, oh, drinking and driving is, like, a thing. And, you know, and since kids are mostly playing these games, they're like, well, we don't want to promote that in it, so, yeah, we have them drink Monster all the time. But it's like, you know, realistically, when we're kind of hanging out, you know, having beers and drinking and stuff, and maybe the only time we're not really drinking beers is, like, when we're at the diner, kind of shooting the shit. Basically, the Longhorn is just a bar. The hell are you doing? Oh, okay, I gotcha.
Dude, you gotta chill. Take it down a notch. You see what he posted, man? It's like he just did that to throw it in my face, yo.
Nah, man.
And to top it all off, Robin's hanging me those risky ass wipes.
Hey, hey.
Wow.
Down.
This is PG-13, bro. How
about some pool, all three of us?
Can, dog. Hey, just got a message from Travis, though. He's headed that way. Hook up with him. I'll see what I can do.
Cool. I'm headed that way, so I'll meet you guys over there.
This game is really pushing that T rating. This damn near rated M. Nah. It's like ass wipes. They swear in the name of God. Yeah, this guy's trying too hard to be super edgy. I mean, come on, if Batman Arkham Knight can get an M rating based on atmosphere alone, then yeah. That's how you do it right. It's like, oh yeah, it's like, okay, we're gonna tell a really, really dark story here. And because of certain thematic elements, yeah, we have to get the M rating for this game. Whereas on the other side of the coin, basically, when the animated version tried to do the same thing with the Killing Joke, it's like, well, we get the R rating, but we're not going to utilize the full extent of that R rating. We're just going to kind of just softly kind of just skim over some stuff because, you know, it may be too serious for our younger viewers. And I'm like, yo, the purpose of you getting an R rating is for you to go all out with the story because the material is so dark. But did you just say hello, Melissa? Oh, I don't think she liked that. You picked up the phone, Melissa's voice, he just hung it up. She's not a telemarketer, bro. Are you happy with your insurance? Click. Wow. It's like, this is just a friendly reminder. You have events that you need to do. Please do them in a timely fashion. Thank you, Melissa. From Eddie's Challenge. Is. Eddie's challenges. It's plural. Gotta remember that.
Not bad, bro. Rob's right about you. See you out there.
Those risky devil ass wipes. Billiardton Bar.
Yo.
Where's Travis at?
I don't know.
Look, Magnus posted a new challenge. I must have been tripping thinking I could take on that guy.
Relax, man. You did good out there. Both of you.
Good isn't good enough. You don't make history by being good. This guy was great, man. I wanted to be great.
You think Magnus isn't rattled? He sees two young guns chasing him down in his own backyard. Not one. Huh? This guy, man. Do I have to spell it out for you?
You're on his radar, Spikey.
Next time, I'll get you, man.
Yeah.
Oh. Fighting talk.
Okey-dokey, so what to do now? Time trial? Is that Manu's thing? Yeah, it's like Manu's icon. Damn you, Namkeel!
Alright. Once you nail this practice, we can move on.
I got a better car this time. Should be a cakewalk.
Thank you.
I just set up a little run you might want to try. Nothing crazy, but I think it'll be worth your time. Cheers.
What? I was like, I wasn't paying attention to that phone call. Yeah, my car was like sideways and not, you know, on the ground sideways, but actually in the air sideways. So, yeah. The hands-free device is really coming in handy right about now. Damn you, neck, you! I feel that this race is inspired by a cop chase. Bitch, move! And we failed. And now you know why it's called Damn You, Neck You.